What is a clear and objective food crime that people are getting away with because we're fighting about pineapple pizza? I let a guy couch surf at my place for a while and he would sit with a tube of Pringles, a thing of ketchup, and one of mustard, and eat the whole tube, squeezing ketchup and mustard on each one. He also tried to fuck my mom. Some days I struggle with which of those irritates me more. One time my girlfriend ordered French toast, topped with berries and whipped cream, for brunch once. She has the diet of an 11-year-old. Instead of being topped with whipped cream though, the kitchen mistakenly topped it with creamy horseradish sauce. Now, I know, mistakes happen. Not the crime. But we communicated the issue to our server, he spoke with the chef, who then came out and spoke with us and apologized. It was a simple labeling mix-up in the kitchen. He corrected it, all good. Before he left though, he kind of laughed to himself, and said, "You know what's funny, we've had four other people order that this morning, but you are the first to say anything about it," and then walked back to the kitchen. That means, four people had French toast for brunch topped with horseradish, ate it, and said nothing. They were just okay with it. The number of people who won't speak up when the food they paid for is done terribly astounds me. I've been putting soy sauce on grapes, is that one? This needs more attention. Get help. My stepdad knew a man who loved ranch dressing. Ate it with everything. I said fine, no big deal. But when he told me the man mixed ranch and water and drank it, I knew that man needed to be sentenced to death. Dude was a fucking alien. Probably Sugar Water's cousin from MIB. Friend of a friend, from Eastern Europe, went to NYC years ago. He went to some cheap canteen and got a bowl of soup. The tables in that place were long and everyone could sit everywhere, so you can get strangers sitting right next to you, which is what happened to this guy. The man next to him got a bowl of soup too. European guy put sour cream in his soup, while the American guy put ketchup. They both looked at each other, like what the fuck are you doing? Edit, since a lot of people are asking, I think it was cabbage soup with meat, kind of like a watery stew or something. Someone in another post is putting watermelon on his pizza. Like WTF dude. Previous boss of mine used to eat packaging peanuts straight out of recently arrived shipments. What's the problem? They're made from cornstarch. Yeah, but you know what? Carry on. There's entertainment value to be had from you doing that, even if there's no nutritional value or flavor. My local restaurant once served mozzarella pizza with marshmallows. I think they meant to put marshmallows with chocolate, but things got mixed up on the way. Edit, for everyone correcting it to be marshmallows, my apologies. English isn't my first language, but he'll never again commit this crime. I saw a dude eat a frozen popsicle with a fork and knife. People who put ketchup on their porridge. Who the actual living fuck? Typically, American YouTubers tasting Aussie or Kiwi snacks, who try a whole spoonful of Marmite / Vegemite on their first time trying it. Luckily I read about how you should use Vegemite before I tried it. I spread the thinnest layer I could on some toast, I think with a bit of butter. It's been a while. That shit still tasted absolutely revolting. I have an aunt that will always use sugar instead of salt in mashed potatoes. I think prison is the only option. Death. You mean death. Edit, thanks anonymous stranger for my first award. My neighbor used to pull all the cheese off her pizza and cover it in ketchup. For me it was when my old roommate would eat an onion like it was an apple. Cereal plus water, instead of milk. My mom's told me repeatedly her family was poor when she was younger, so sometimes they couldn't afford milk and would just eat water on shit like cornflakes, and every time I'm like, you have the option to eat it dry, WTF. Putting a ton of ketchup on everything. It physically hurts when I see people covering their entire pizza slice with ketchup. Wait, roll on back. Oreos dipped in orange juice. Fuck this thread, I'm out. My cousin eats a ketchup sandwich while dipping it in his coffee. Edit, oh wow. I didn't know this would blow up. Thanks for the awards, guys. That's it. You just won the thread. I've got a tough stomach and a pretty adventurous palate, but that made me wanna puke. Making French fries out of cauliflower is okay if you want to, but telling me that I'm literally not going to be able to tell the difference between that and potato? That's the crime. It's just insanity. I can tell, as can everyone else with working taste buds who pays even the slightest bit of attention. Cauliflower is a great vegetable. You can make rice out of it, you can use it to bulk up a curry, you can slice and roast or fry it. But it tastes like cauliflower. It's never going to taste like potato or rice or meat. So let's not pretend. It can be very tasty in its own right, but as a substitute for something else, you're always going to be disappointed. Eating breakfast cereal with water. My husband is a monster. I love him, but has he spent time in prison, or did he grow up very poor? Wendy's got rid of spicy nuggets, but just brought them back for a limited time only. I never understood why the company would get rid of such a popular item. Scraping the toppings right off of pizza and eating it separately. It's blasphemy. My mom did this after she had surgery. She really wanted some pizza but couldn't handle the bread. Taking excessive food at buffets and wasting most of it. It should be a crime if not a conviction of the conscience. Not asking permission and grabbing food from someone's plate with your bare hands. Pineapple ain't shit. Japanese wife puts mayo, egg, corn, potato and french fries on pizza like it's normal. Work at a pizza place. A lady brought in some corn and wanted half of it on her pizza. We all thought it was weird until later. We charred some and put it on her crust with salsa, cheese, peppers and onions. That shit was good. People actually drinking milk coke. Add some vodka and Kahlua, it's a solid choice. Not breaking Kit Kats into their individual sticks before you eat them. A friend of mine once spit sideways into a Kit Kat and we were all horrified. Give him a break. YouTubers eating ice cream with their hands at convenience stores and then putting the carton back in the freezer. That's a plain crime. People who put ketchup on everything. My meal. She makes one of those microwave ramen cup of noodles, makes it normally, with the veggies and seasoning, throws a cut-up hot dog in it, then puts probably 1/8 cup of Italian salad dressing in it. She also takes a steamer bag of mixed veggies, microwaves it for 8 minutes, instead of the 4 to 5 it says on the bag, then opens it, pours it into a microwave vegetable steamer and steams it for 10 minutes, puts it in a bowl, covers it in Italian dressing and stirs it up into a pile of mush. She has a gallon jar of dill pickles on her countertop. I noticed a fucking straw in the jar, and made the mistake of asking about it. Turns out, she was craving pickles so bad that over 2 weeks, she drank 80% of the juice out of the gallon jar straight, then started throwing the pickles in her blender to get more juice out of them. She also makes a 2-gallon pitcher of iced tea with over 4 cups of sugar, and drinks one pitcher every 24 hours. She doesn't like water, so tea is all she drinks. Her husband has his own pitcher next to hers in the fridge because he can't drink hers. A quick Google search says 1 cup sugar equals 214 grams. So 4 cups is 860 grams of sugar she's consuming a day just in her tea. Makes me nauseous to think about it. The pickle juice thing is a very effective home cure for most cramps, but the rest of that stuff is just straight food abuse. Brazilians are putting chocolate on pizza and Swedes are putting bananas on theirs. They are clearly the real enemy here. Edit, by no means a pizza purist. I love butter chicken and bacon ranch pizzas ect. I also tolerate pineapple, even if it's not my favorite. A lot of the replies sound great as long as they aren't made with the traditional tomato sauce and cheese combo. I once ate a peanut butter sandwich with tuna on it. God, that sounds like a joke sandwich they'd make up in a cartoon to be like "Uck, peanut butter and tuna?" for a kid's school lunch. My girlfriend loves to eat banana and mayonnaise sandwiches, and she thinks nothing is wrong with it, but it sounds terrible. Massive amounts of food being thrown away by restaurants and such at the end of the day instead of finding ways for it to be donated or allowing employees to take it home, etc., etc. Edit, so this is 2 weeks old, but to the people saying there's legal/liability problems with doing this, those laws are part of the problem and it's really the entire food industry, not just restaurants. Obviously a more efficient, less wasteful, food industry wouldn't solve everything, but it'd help. My catering company donates so much leftover food to a company that repurposes it for meals for underserved families in my area. What they do with it is amazing. I have a friend who eats mayonnaise with vegetable soup. You're all thinking of foods getting put together than shouldn't be, but what about underappreciated slash overhated foods? Brussels sprouts are delicious when cooked well, but everyone acts like they're gastronomic enemy number one. Wasting food. How many people are incredibly unadventurous with food? I've had several friends that I have trouble finding somewhere to eat with, because they're limited to basically pizza or burgers or chicken nuggets. I want to go to an Indian place? They've never had it before, and definitely don't want to now. The water in Flint, Michigan. My daughter, and hot sauce. It's okay in reasonable amounts, but she can go through a large bottle in a couple of days. It would probably last longer if she didn't drink it straight up. Power move. My girlfriend's daughter eats steak like it's going out of style. She loves perfectly cooked medium rare expensive steaks too. None of that cheap sirloin shit, she only wants the best kinds of steaks you can buy. If we go to a restaurant that has a $50 steak on the menu, you bet your ass that she is asking for it. And hashtag X200B, and hashtag X200B, that seems perfectly normal and reasonable. Until you find out that she pours ketchup on top of her steaks. Not like a little bit either, I mean the entire fucking steak is covered with ketchup. I'm pretty sure this kind of act breaks a part of the Geneva Convention. You should see what people do with food in pornos. Two girls, one cup of chocolate ice cream coming right up. Putting soy and corn byproducts into everything. Or palm oil. Expanding on baklava in any way. Stop. Baklava is a gift from the gods on its own. Stop doing weird shit to it. Forget about arguing for pineapples on pizza. We need to destroy mayo and pee pizza lovers. Not eating pizza crust. Not eating the crust is a very low form of existence. When people put whatever sauce they're having with their fries all over the fries instead of to the side like a normal person. I used to do that until I realized a few things. 1, you can't cover all the fries without filling the tub with sauce. 2, you will get your hands covered in sauce as you try to pick out the fries. 3, it's not practical as you constantly have to add more sauce. 4, they get soggy from the saturation. 5, you get the ones that are cold and covered in runny sauce. Now I just put it in a corner and dip. Like a normal human being. Edited to add a few more very important notes. Thanks, Redditors. I have a cousin that always puts ketchup on his foie gras when we have family dinners during holiday festivities. I saw a video about people that enjoy PB and mayo sandwiches, and I have never wanted to commit murder so badly. Bananas do not belong in fridges, put them in the fruit bowl. Edit, alright, I've decided a plan because I'm a lazy ass. If you are going to use the banana as an ingredient, then if it must, then it can go in the fridge. If they are to be eaten alone, then they stay away from the fridge. My boyfriend puts barbecue sauce in spaghetti bolognese. I also used to visit a place that put avocado and corn on pizza. Safe to say I didn't order it. Corn on pizza is fucking amazing. I went to a place that had it as a topping option. I thought, why not? I'm adventurous with food. Did not regret it whatsoever. The taste plays well against all the other flavors, and the pop when you bite into it is satisfying. Best addition to pizza I've discovered in a long time. My cousins drink their cereal and eat waffles frozen. Frozen waffles are actually pretty good, but the first one is a crime. They probably put their milk in first, 2 SMH. And GT, my cousins drink their cereal. NGL, I do that sometimes. Especially when there's only a bit of soggy stuff and flavored milk left. It's a laziness thing mostly,